PJ DeSantis, Julie Kedzie, Scottish Rite Temple, our main event of Invicta FC 30. The Southpaw Fry in the whites, Roots Kumina Grusender in the black.
You know, we mentioned this before, but Grusender is so fast with some of her strikes, and she's really got some pinpoint accuracy.
In the clinch here early, big left hand there by Fry.
No real feeling out process here. They're definitely ready to engage immediately.
Two of the best in the world at 105 pounds, fighting for the most prestigious title in the atomweight division.
You can see Grusender's trying to drop her level now, grab a leg, secure a takedown there against Fry. She's also pulling the upper body back so that Fry, oh, nice spin out by Fry. Big left hand.
Very technically sound is the Texan.
Ooh.
Flurry of punches. Adam waits so fast.
And one thing about Grusender, she rarely shows when she's been hit. From what we've seen, she's kind of ice cold in the face and just keeps moving forward.
Yeah, very poised is Grusender. Her first fight against Fernanda Barjos, she had a huge weight cut, and she handled that with ease.
She also ate a lot of overhand rights, if I remember correctly. Nice left there from Fry again. And now we see Grusender's in on the leg, pulling it up.
Alicia Zapatella in action earlier, now tweeting about tonight's action. She was impressive in her Invicta FC debut.
And both of these fighters, one of the reasons this is exciting, both got very good cage wrestling. Both are hard to take down against the cage, and both are good at throwing takedowns against the cage. Another big spin out punch there from Fry.
Yeah, Fry really showing her aggression there and ability to cut angles.
Grusender controlling the center of the cage quite well here. And she does pick it up in later rounds, TJ. We saw that in the Barjos fight.
Coming forward with punches is Grusender back in the clinch.
We saw Fry was digging with her left hand for an underhook. She's almost wrapped around the head, but she's really looking for cross space. You don't want to guillotine from right there because Grusender is so tight in on her, she would just pull her to the ground. And you can see Fry's trying to drop her hips, split her legs, and get the weight off of her own, or I guess take the takedown away from the Finnish fighter.
Now Fry paying a little bit more attention to that head.
And she goes right for that guillotine when I say, I don't know if that's smart. And she's doing a nice job of kind of doing a transition. Grusender very, very deep on that takedown, looking to take the back almost and pull Fry to the ground. And she does, sort of. Fry is still up a little, yeah.
We'll see if she can secure the position. Fry definitely not exactly where she wants to be.
And Grusender has some very vicious ground and pound from this backpack position. You can see she's hooking that leg. She's going to try and drag Fry off of the fence so she can secure a better position on the back.
And credit to Grusender for not getting overzealous here and trying to make something that isn't there happen and lose a dominant position.
Yeah, patience is all right here, TJ. It's really about these tiny inches. If Fry is able to get that elbow to the inside and not extended, she'll be able to get out, and she is. She's able to spin and get her back to the cage.
Nice adjustment by Jinyu Fry. Working some shots to the side of the head of Grusender.
And Grusender still has double underhook, so she's still in the middle. Oh, wrenches her down.
The strength by the Finn on display, some quick right hands by Grusender finding a home. Minute left here in round number one. Scheduled 5 5-minute rounds. Atomweight title on the line.
Really, it's like a python with that pressure, shoulder pressure, dragging her down, and again, trying to find a position to ground and pound, expose the head, expose the chin.
Trying to get free is Fry.
Ooh, Grusender's on her back. I don't know if her right arm is all the way underneath. I can't see from this angle, but you can see Fry is trying a backdoor escape now from that back position. She may, Grusender's got her hooks in now. She might be trying to extend her out, and she's underneath at least the left armpit of Fry.
Looks like maybe she could be trying to attack that left arm of Jinyu Fry.
Yeah, it looks like it. You know, it was almost a triangle, but you see Fry's head pop out, but her left arm is now still inside in a Kimura.
Time not on her side. Still could make something happen, though. Nice position for Mina Gersinger to end the round, but Jinyu Frye survives, and the tone has been set by the Finnish fighter in round number one.
Yeah, I think, you know, what she's wanting to do is kind of counter a little bit, come into the inside, push Frye to the cage, and then use that to work, use that to bounce off her shots, use that to grind into her, pull her down, break her down, and get that ground and pound in. Once she can, find the submission.
We are scheduled 25 minutes here for the atomweight title. So a lot of time for both fighters to change their game plans up. Tell me what you think Jinyu Frye will need to do here in round number two.
Well, I think she needs to be more aggressive on her feet with her motion. She was doing nice punch spin-offs from the cage. She got out of bad positions quite a few times, but the fact that she's getting to the cage means she's stepping back too much, TJ. More lateral motion. She needs to move more, especially, I'm telling you, she's got a really sharp right hook. I'd like to see that employed a lot more with her footwork.
Mina Gersinger had some success. Any adjustments you'd like to see her make in the second round?
Honestly, just turn the volume up. I think it's there. I think, again, like I said, she accelerates as the longer the fight goes on. Well, at least in third, three-round fights, so we'll see how that goes.
Round number two underway. Mina Gersinger in the black, Jinyu Frye in the white. Right hand by the Finn now. Clinch initiated. Frye trying to put Gersinger into the fence.
Yeah, you can see she's reversed there. Frye was reaching a little bit too far with that right leg. Now Gersinger's working for those double underhooks. Frye has got double under at least with that one. She's wrapped around the head again. Now she's kind of trying to find that spin out. The amount of pressure that Gersinger's putting on her with her shoulder and with her head is pushing her into the cage so that she's able to be leveraged up. Frye is standing on one leg trying to kind of create a defense, but that actually doesn't give her that much defense there because she's not being struck. Now, she turned to her right, which is, unfortunately, giving up her back. And you can see Gersinger, again, backpack pulling her down.
Gersinger in business here trying to secure the position. Frye able to turn back into her. Now Frye able to circle off the fence, get back to space. Nice right hand by Gersinger, found a home.
Done there by Jinyu Frye. She read those angles beautifully, but unfortunately her back, not back to the cage again. Now look at the way Gersinger is pushing with that elbow, her right elbow. She's bracing and pushing. Jin comes over to have the vicious left.
Big wind up with that left hand. Then Jin kind of looked at it a little bit. I don't know if she hurt her hand in that punch or...
I'm not sure. Look at how upright Gersinger is. That actually is beneficial for Frye if she does more level changes, but she is susceptible to that right hand the way she's moving to her left.
Some straight rights finding a home for Brutsku. Big wind up to the body there by Frye. Kick block there. Now back into the clinch.
Now it was right hands that cut Frye in the title fight against Ayaka Hamasaki, and it was a straight, I think it was a right-left-right against Sohee Ham that lost her the title and actually, you know, put her out. So this is going to be interesting to see. I really don't think she should be moving too much to that direction.
This fight not really going the way that Jinyu Frye wants it to early, but she's very composed. She's been in these situations before. This is where she can, you know, call upon that championship experience, and we'll see if she can make the proper adjustments. But right now, Mina Gersinger fighting the game plan that she wanted to employ.
And putting a lot of pressure, a lot of weight, and then just this, I guess, I don't know, not exactly backpacking, but she's laying on her almost with that weight, forcing Frye to kind of carry her and then find her positions to hit from. Frye's got excellent hips, and she knows how to move out of those positions, but, you know, her leg is grabbed now, and there's a lot of pressure on her chest.
If you want some free stuff, text INVICTA to 555-888. You will get some goodies from our sponsors. Plus, you'll be entered to win some autographed fight gloves. Again, text INVICTA to 555-888.
watch the way Grusander sometimes comes up on the toe of her left foot, TJ. That actually will help her duck underneath if she needs to explode and get into a double leg. Now, she pulled it out, but she gets where she can actually get, lift her leg up, and then plant hard on the inside or throw those knees. It's a good leveraging thing to do. Her weight's primarily in her upper body right there, and she's able to use her legs lightly.
Championship fight, referee Greg Franklin letting them work here. He's getting closer, a little bit of a stalemate here. And he separates them back in space.
So Fry looked to her corner really quickly.
Final 30 seconds of round number two. Grusander back in on a takedown attempt.
Fry is so smart in these exchanges, getting underhooks, splitting her legs, but she's also dealing with somebody just like really resting on her there. It's a frustrating thing to do defensively. Nice spin off. Ooh, to the kick again.
Ten minutes in the books. Jinyu Fry showing that she can come alive at any moment despite being controlled, but Mina Grusander has her game going, and Jinyu Fry needs to break that heading into the third round.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting just watching the way their hips and their legs move throughout. Like I said, Grusander stands so upright, but when she's on the cage, it's almost like she makes somebody just, she drives into them, pinpoints them, not with her hands and her punches, but she pinpoints them with her upper body strength and her head, and then uses her legs to change positions. Fry does a nice job defending against a lot of that, though, but she has been giving up some back positions. Now, Grusander threw a really nice right head kick here to Fry, who kind of shook it off. But then again, Fry throws her own kicks off of these spin-offs, which is really nicely timed. She kind of hit more in the shoulder there than flush to the head, but she's definitely trained something where she's stepping at an angle and finding the head on that step.
Jinyu Fry, Mina Grusander headed into round number three. We are scheduled for five. Atomweight title on the line.
See a little swelling on the right corner of the eye of Jinyu Fry right now.
Again, TJ DeSantis, Julie Kedzie, Scottish Rite Temple here in Kansas City. This is our main event of Invicta FC 30. Fry changing it up, gets a takedown. Gotta worry about this guillotine though.
She is in a guillotine. You can see Grusander's turning her body to say, trying to corkscrew through. And now Fry is fighting hands, trying to push up to get leverage. It doesn't look like Grusander's hands are connected anymore. Yep, Fry's out.
Close guard here now, opening it up is Grusander. Fry posturing up, trying to clear the legs.
Oh. Fry tried to pass and actually put herself back in the guard. Now, like I said in the comments fight, Fry has actually never been stopped but, you know, with an armbar in a professional fight, but she was thrown in quite a few of them from this position from Ashley Cummins because she does kind of wind up when she throws those big shots. From here, it's time for her to actually shimmy her shoulders in, break that high guard, and then find a position to strike from.
High guard employed here by Grusander. Fry needs to be careful, gets her arm free, now tries to explode with some offense.
Got some international rivalry going on in the crowd right now. Chance of Finland and then USA.
Invicta FC committed to bringing the world's best fighters to their divisions. The atomweight title here, truly a world championship.
And yeah, Grusander's climbing those legs up again as she secures, you know, she secures the wrist. Fry senses this, jerks out, hits her, but actually isn't looking, she's not getting the pass. She's pushing forward still, just a little bit too much. And now she's wrapped kind of in a triangle leg position anyway. I don't know if it's a full triangle. And Grusander's again, trying for those wrists. Nice elbow there. Just pulling those, just extending her forward.
Fry posturing up now, throwing some hammer fists. And again, Grusander brings that guard up high. Really can't be too comfortable, even when you're in top position in your guard.
Yeah, that's a nice little double jerk out from Fry, but then she dives right back into a guard position. I think she's content to hit from here. She did get the decision over Cummins, and a lot of things happened from this position. However, when you're striking with one arm and your opposite arm or wrist is trapped, it does put you at a disadvantage, or excuse me, I guess a danger when it comes to being submitted.
Halfway point of the fight. 2.5 remain here in round number 3. USA chants being drowned out by boos. Never thought I'd really hear that in Kansas City with an American fighting a Finn. Exchange of hammer fists.
Fry pulls out to pull back in, but you can see that Grusinder is blocking her out with her foot on the hip. Fry tries to drop it down, but instead gets caught again in a guillotine in the closed guard. Not a tight guillotine, though.
The guard very active of Mina Grusinder. And really, every single time that Fry gives an inch, Grusinder brings that guard higher.
It's true, and you know, Fry is doing things with her hips. She's pulling her hips straight out. She's trying to ride the quarter turns that Grusinder's trying to do to get some more length on those. But Grusinder really happy to kind of get onto those wrists and then just climb her legs up and let her arm bars almost come from a straight-on position or be built from a straight-on position. I mean, she's climbed over and trapped her own arm.
90 seconds left here in round number 3.
This is where Fry has to be not emotional about her, you know, her striking stuff and stay very, very technical. Her right arm's pretty trapped, but like I like that little upward, that bounce with the elbow right there she did. That's good.
Scramble upcoming here. Grusinder gives up her back. Fry on
Very fast by Fry.
And the choke is Junior Fry. Mina Grusinder needs to survive. A lot of time here for the Texan to work.
She's not quite under the chin, but she is across the mouth. Grusinder gives a little thumbs up to Greg Franklin. But flattening her out right now is very smart of Fry to do. Now you can see Grusinder's trying to work a backdoor escape. She's trying to free her legs. Her feet are in motion, trying to move position. And she's staying patient as her mouth is being kind of squished.
Now, you don't necessarily have to have the arm under the chin to elicit a tap. You can crush that jaw. She gives up on her
foot.
Some left elbows. Grusinder has to move.
Yeah, you're right, TJ. I was very enthusiastic about that. Yes, you can crush the jaw, and it's extremely painful. And can do damage to the lower teeth as well.
We see the veteran savvy here of Jin Yu Fry. She was down early in rounds number 1 and number 2, but this third round firmly in the books for her.
And Grusinder again trying that high guard with the right foot on the hip and the left leg climbing up.
Well, we've got ourselves a fight.
Grusinder wanted to go.
Yeah, I mean, we talked to Mina Grusinder ahead of the fight. She said, you know, if I can get a finish, I'd love to get a finish early. But she was almost looking forward to the opportunity to fight in the championship rounds and, well, wish granted.
Yeah, you know, and I don't blame her. Sorry for talking over you there. I don't blame her. She looks very fresh, whereas, you know, Fry, who's been in situations before, is kind of looking down a little bit, trying to get her air back. Grusinder looks excited and fresh, despite not having really gotten very much from that elbow. You saw Fry right here, most significant, I think, moment here, jumping the back and locking that right arm around the head and neck, and then, you know, getting some heavy ground and pound right here on the Finn's face, while Grusinder turns into her, blocks out with that knee, and gets back to a full guard position.
Seconds out, championship rounds on deck. Mina Grusinder and Jin Yu Fry. This fight for the vacant atomweight championship of the world. And round number 4 underway. Again, TJ DeSantis, Julie Kedzie, Scottish Rite Temple. Mina Grusinder in the black, Jin Yu Fry in the white.
I love the discipline of Grusinder's hands. You know, they're so quick and they come right back to her face every single time.
It was Fry who went for the takedown in round number 3 and secured it. We'll see if she wants to go back to that well again here in round number 4.
And I think that's a good idea for her in that her movement seems to push her back into the cage right here. You know, judges watch that she's getting some shots in here, but it's mostly defense. So they see one person, you know, launching these big offenses.
And it's hard to win rounds, you know, in this pattern. This is what we saw in rounds number 2 with Mina Grusinder controlling Jin Yu Fry. It's hard to win a round when your back is against the fence.
So we've got a little elbow smash back and forth here. There's a nice brace from the left arm of Grusinder across the neck of Fry, which must be very painful. Blood is, I believe, coming from the, what is it, the right side of Fry's head. It's hard to see from this angle. Somebody's bleeding, TJ. Now you see Grusinder's dug in again.
Now there it is. It looks like maybe in the hairline. Virginia Fry.
Which is actually not a great place to be cut because that can drip right into the eyes. And look at Grusinder's changing her level. She's muscling down into that high crotch position. She abandons it. Fry is able to pull her back up.
Nice knee on the inside there by Jenny Fry.
You see Grusinder's trying to use her right arm across the hips to extend that left arm and probably throw another elbow with her left hand. Fry sees that. Oh, there's that elbow. There's a right elbow, too. You know, Fry was trying to control the wrist there, but she wasn't able to sustain it.
Very gritty fight here up against the fence. Mandy Grusinder has cut open Jenny Fry. 3 minutes left to work in round number four.
And they're both such physical atomweights, TJ. They're both so strong and really in tune with the way to use their hips and their bodies to get control of these exchanges. Right now, it's all Grusinder, you know, putting pressure on Fry. Ah, nice spin out again.
See if Fry can capitalize here. The latter half of round number four. She is back at space.
And I think for Fry, it's those fakes and feints, like I said at the top of the show, fakes and feints to that takedown again. Put Grusinder on her back.
See the hand speed there of Jenny Fry. Grusinder getting Fry to react.
And I'm thinking they game planned for right or left hooks to the body there, but they're not really as effective for Fry as they might have been earlier in earlier rounds. I think she needs to hit over the top of that guard and again shoot for takedown. Shot for the takedown.
This is where Fry had success in the third round, but now Grusinder trying to back up into the fence and maybe stand.
Incredibly savvy movement there from Grusinder. She's now in a position to extract a leg because she has her back on the fence, and she does so.
Nicely done by Finland's Minna Grusinder.
It's really hard to control somebody's hips right there. Nice.
Back at space, Grusinder immediately takes the center of the cage. She wants Fry's back on the perimeter.
You know, it's interesting, Fry at times is outstepping Grusinder with her out on her right leg, as you should as a lefty, but Grusinder is still stepping inside on that. Nice shot there from Fry. The lateral motion is actually controlled by the fin, so I was quite wrong in my predictions there.
Looked like Fry was trying to initiate the clinch there and maybe make something happen, but Grusinder puts her back into the fence. 1 minute remains in round number four.
And by extending her right arm out, she's trying to block the hips of her opponent up against the cage and then use the left arm, extract the left arm and do work with it, or use that for hooking positions to open things up. It's smart, it's good fighting. You can see Fry is digging for that underhook. She does not want that kind of leverage against her. They both have such good wrestling instincts. You know, Fry's counter wrestling is very good right here on the cage.
And while she is effective with her counter wrestling, it's a place that she can't remain for prolonged periods of time, though, should this fight go the distance.
Exactly. I mean, Grusinder is in control of what's going on. And if you're counter wrestling like that but not launching an offense, then you're on the defense. So you are, in fact, not controlling what's happening during the fight.
Final 10 seconds. Well, four rounds in the books. Mina Grusinder implementing the game plan that it appears that she drew up, but we see some swelling underneath that right eye. You can guarantee that will be a target for Jenny Fry in round number five.
Yeah, and honestly, I think that may have come from those little elbow exchanges that happened. I didn't see any particular left-hand land flush, maybe earlier on in the fight, but not in this round, but I did see some really, you know, they kind of went nuts on each other with those elbows in the clinch.
Scottish Rite Temple coming alive. An atomweight champion will be crowned. There is only 5 minutes left for these ladies to work. If you're in the corner of Jenny Fry, Julie, what do you do to ensure that this title's coming home with you?
She's got to put her on her back and she's got to finish her. You know, right now I only have one round securely in Jin's favor. That doesn't mean she hasn't gotten more. She's definitely had a lot of output when it comes, but with her back against the cage, it's hard to see how people are going to judge that. And I think the Finn has controlled much of the action in this fight by pinning her.
I'll co-sign 100% right there. Mina Grusander having a lot of success here. 20 minutes in the books. Will the second Invicta FC championship be headed to Finland? Or will Jin Yu Frye get the title that she has wanted for so long? We will find out. Fifth and final round underway. We'll see if Frye turns up the output here.
And she's attacking that leg, the inside of that leg, very well, but not doing anything once she lands it. You know, I think there has to be some sort of effort from her offense after that. She's hitting it, but it's not stopping the motion of her opponent. Frye, I mean. Mina's just kind of stalking her down.
You never know what the judges say, but you got to believe that the clock is not an ally of Jin Yu Frye. Especially not when Mina Grusander is able to get this type of control.
Yeah, and that takedown was easily defended. You know, I'm wondering if Jin's a little bit winded at this point, or, you know, she just kind of saw an opening, but it didn't quite land there, and she got pinned again. She's free, and I think she's got to put something in front of those takedown attempts in order to get them to land, and she's got to change her level a little bit lower. A lot of swelling there from the right eye of Grusander.
Grusander very confident when she arrived at Invicta last March. She felt that she was going to be a factor in this 105-pound division from the get-go, and she could just be 3.5 minutes away from securing that title. But never underestimate the power, speed, and ability of Jin Yu Frye. We are on Twitter at TJ DeSantis, at JulesK_fighter, at Invicta Fights, hashtag InvictaFC30. Guys over at Sherdog.com watching tonight, we appreciate that.
Big left hand there landed for Frye, but she's continuing to move backwards and to her right into Mina's power side. I'm liking those kicks. I just want more out of that, you know? Just like that single right hand that Mina's throwing. Either one of them can throw a hook right now, I'd be really pleased with.
A lot of movement here from Frye. She's trying to make Grusander react and then come over the top. Not exactly sure. We won't find out if she's controlled like this. Crowd coming alive here in the Scottish Rite Temple for Mina Grusander. Frye able to get free.
You can see she was spinning off and probably trying to throw some kind of knee to the head, but was unable to do that. Is backing into the cage, though, again.
Less than 2 minutes remain here. Jin Yu Frye, a lot of action, but not really throwing with volume here, Julie. I don't know if she's worried about Grusander getting that clinch again and controlling her or what, but she needs to go.
She does, and honestly, that left hand that she threw earlier was just beautifully. It landed very well for her. I'd like to see some more of those. Grusander, again, just stalking her down, like, just like, I mean, it's just her technique is just really beautiful, the way she's using her footwork to go through. And Jin Yu Frye has such nice lateral motion, but she keeps going right into that power side. And it's a little worrisome. She's throwing a really nice left kick to the inside leg, but need more volume. That was a longer way of me saying what you just said, I think.
You sounded better.
Oh, nice.
1 minute left to go. The atomweight title on the line. Mina Grusander could be seconds away from it. Jin Yu Frye throws that left hand.
Jin's corner getting very vocal about what they want from her. They're saying she's open, it's open, it's open. They really want her to accelerate now.
30 seconds. It's one thing to say that you will be a champion. It is another thing to actually go out and do it. Mina Grusander showed up with confidence. She talked the talk. And tonight, she's walked the walk.
Nice exchange there. Both are opening up just a little bit. They know, time's up.
25 minutes in the books. Mina Grusander. Jinyu Fry. What a performance by the Finn. I gotta believe that Finland gets its second Invicta FC title here tonight.
You know, I'm kind of with you there, TJ. I thought we saw some really good moments from Jinyu Fry, but I thought Mina Grusander pushed forward the entire time. She controlled a lot of the distancing. She was put on her back. She gave up her back at one point, but I do think that with that cage work and that pinning, such a crucial part of MMA, that kind of control against the cage, you know, she showed mastery in that area.
And we saw adjustments. We talk about five-round fights. You need to make the proper adjustments to walk away with the decision. Jinyu Fry seemed to be in business in the third round. She got a takedown. She was in top position. Mina Grusander was very active off of her back. But short of that round, Jinyu Fry really wasn't able to make a claim for any other round. And that's credit to Mina Grusander for coming up with a very tactical game plan, making some adjustments, but ultimately sticking to what she wanted to do in this fight.
I totally agree. I think, you know, Grusander really brought this fresh, overwhelming kind of pressure to this fight that was needed to slow down the American fighter.
Judges tallying their tens and nines. A new atomweight champion is about to be crowned. Mina Grusander really doing a great job. Jinyu Fry was game, but we will see what the judges say. Joe Martinez will crown our champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Here are the totals. Fernando Marquez has it 49-46. Both Henry Gary and Ross Swanberg have it 48-47. All three for your winner by unanimous decision, the new atomweight champion of the world out of Arlington, Texas, Jinyu Fry.